Over Labor Day weekend, family and friends came together to honor one very special woman. She's a wife, she's a mother, she's a grandma, and more than anything, she's an inspiration.
This is your birthday, Bayo Grandma. I hope you like it.
Doing the nose thing, and this guy, this like man, comes up to me and is like, "You can do it too." And I was like, "Yeah, I can." And he was like, "It's because your nostrils are thin. It's because your nostrils are thin."
I'm like, oh, I did not know that.
You didn't know?
No. Yeah.
The bedrooms. We thank you for use the place. We love to come back.
That was this.
I learned that was very good.
And you know, it's like we didn't say it.
Everyone brought their favorite games. We started on Friday night with Blank Slate.
Yeah. Okay.
All right.
What do you guys got?
What occurred to me first, what?
Second grade.
Second base. I had that one. Baseball family.
Second grade.
Second grade. They're really big now.
Okay, Ian, what do you, Kathleen, what do you guys got?
Pink cushion.
Pink cushion.
Yeah, told you.
Darn, cushion.
No.
What do you guys got?
Oh, no. Pine cone.
Kelly.
Pinball. See, we would have got 3 points for pinball. Mud flat.
I love puddle.
Mud.
Ours, we went with muddy.
Oh, we thought about that.
Mud slide.
On Saturday, it was time to go down to the river.
And Colleen, you look great.
Wonderful.
Good.
Yeah, that was our first attempt.
I have my waterproof camera.
So. Oh my god, you are brave.
Oh. You're doing bumper beats.
It's important.
Saturday afternoon came, and it was time to get ready for the party. Hey, it's time for the birthday party.
They just knew they didn't want to be the one.
That was like our number one.
That was my number one.
I remember moving to
Atlanta.
I hated that. I remember moving to Atlanta.
I was there.
Yeah.
Even though it's getting water, it's so
good. That's good.
Can you do a video?
Can you wink at me?
Oh, okay.
Alright, so of course I can't say, I asked the kids to like think, well, whatever, some fun memory if they had one, or, and so I was trying to think of memories, and how can I think of, I mean, I have, so I'm going to cry. Yeah, so I will share, I can't do this, it's stupid.
She's still alive!
Which is you picking me up every single, I think, Wednesday. I had brownies, and you picked me up every Wednesday, and it was just you and me in the car, and you'd drive me home, and I'd say every time, and I you know, I didn't think about it now, but now I know what that meant, like, oh, gotta go get the kid from brownies. So you drove me home, and I'd get to sit in the front seat, and I'd say, what are we having for dinner? And you'd say, spaghetti. And I'm like, yes!
Because Wednesday was spaghetti night.
And we always had spaghetti on Wednesday, which was lovely. So I had that memory. But then, connected to the brownie memory, was that when we moved to Strongsville, and I'm like, okay, where are the brownies? There was no brownie troop. And what did my mom do? She's like, there's no brownie troop? Or no, that wasn't what it was. There was brownies, but they wouldn't let me in.
What'd you do?
I don't remember why. But in something? Any case, you and I think, was it Gwen's mom? Anyway, they said, okay, we're gonna do Campfire Girls then. And I went into Campfire Girls. Do you remember Campfire Girls?
I remember Campfire Girls.
Yeah, but you were like really mad because I was gonna join brownies and something happened. Like they said we're too full or something, and you're like, all right, we're going to Campfire Girls. And then I did Campfire Girls. So anyway, thanks for the rides and getting me into Campfire Girls. And about 100 million other things.
Just thinking earlier today, I was. Tyler knows. I like decorating our house with old things and big old furniture and things that nobody else likes. And earlier today when I was walking in the house, Grandma said, I'm so happy you like old things. But I do think that my love of old things came from spending time at your house.
Oh.
Yeah.
And going to Hartsville. Yeah, for you. Yeah, really? No. And waking up at 2:30 in the morning.
Gave you a cupcake or something.
We got a cranberry muffin.
Yeah, it's always muffin.
And some juice. And some juice. And then we got to the minivan and went, arm, arm.
And we would drive across the state of Ohio.
This was for fun.
Go to Parkville. And at one point I wasn't allowed to buy any stuffed animals. And I said, well, what am I supposed to do there?
Who put that rule in?
You did.
We had a lot.
So I would get Kenny Lofton baseball cards.
Yes.
Yep. But anyway, great. Happy birthday.
Treasure is we had fun. Now I can see we had fun and good times, even if it wasn't with a lot of money. But I didn't know that we had. I thought I got the best Christmas presents. It was all fabulous, and we. We went to the park and made fried eggs and bacon! I was like, oh my gosh, this is the best. At the parks, you know, it was like the best. And then one said, do you want to go to the park? And everybody goes, yes.
I forgot all that.
So we just had, you know, dad saying, get out of the car and get that firewood. Okay. That's a dad. Looking back now, I realize the things that people spend money on to give their kids a good time, and we had a good time without you know, without spending money, and that was a good way to be raised, and, you know, I think I passed that on to my kids.
Yes.
We were talking about that today, that we don't care about fancy cars or fancy purses or... And the other thing is, we have a mom who always has our back, no matter what.
Exactly.
No matter what.
That's
we know, Mom, I love you. Doesn't matter what happens.
She always wants a class list.
That is
Grandma's
true.
Gonna love you no matter what.
That
in fact,
true.
Caitlin posted a meme one time on Facebook, and I thought it's appropriate for Mom to let me get the words right. If you've ever done me wrong, know that my mother knows, and she doesn't like you. Got that thumbs up. So that is mine.
I thought of that one too.
Because some of the first games I ever learned how to play was at your house, and we would play Yahtzee and Pigmania and all these like very kid-friendly games that take, admittedly, a lot of patience to teach little kids how to like play these games and have fun. And that is, from when I remember coming over and like spending time there, just a lot of patience with us, because me and Caitlin were not quiet, and not
bring me into this.
Well, because one thing I remember is we were playing some hide-and-seek running game, and I stood straight up
into the Irish
into
shelf.
One of the shelves and broke a plate basically over my head. Like, an
it was,
plate.
I did that.
Did you?
Yeah.
But it was also my fault because I was chasing you and covering you. It was
that's funny how memories just
Well, grandma camp
right.
was
so
after
true.
Christmas when I needed child care, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah,
like,
no, exactly. Grandma camp, do this stuff, whatever. You had very nice things. But you were always so patient with us. No matter what. So when you're saying like you never doubt that like they're in your corner, it's like
grandma's got your back.
Never doubt it for a second. Yeah. Even when we're being tiny menaces
and
or grown up and sullen. Yeah, no, or like a sullen teenager. It's like
What?
There was this one time when I was in high school when a few of my friends, we went to Costco or like BJ's, one of those, and we bought lots and lots of toilet paper because we were going to go to one of this girl's house who was having a sleepover and toilet paper in their house.
Roll it.
Yeah,
it's a pastime in Strongsville.
Maybe borrowed a card from you or there's.
No,
or,
it was our card.
It was your card, yeah. And I just said, because we said we're sleeping over somebody's house, I said, we want to buy a lot of candy in bulk. But we ended up buying a lot of toilet paper. So, but what happened was we did this, and then either the neighbor or somebody, one of the parents, called the police, and the police came and put us all in the backseat, four of us.
Oh, boy.
And one of the kids' parents were out of town. He was the one that was supposed to be staying like at his house. Another one that was sitting next to me said, if the police call my dad, he's going to take away my Nintendo. And I'm like, really? All right, fine. So I bit the bullet on that one, and they called you guys, and the late at night, which was not good, I'm sure. And so I forget how we got. I think the police took us all home, and you were not happy, obviously. But then I remember the next day you saying, so that's why you hunted the Costco. Just cut your
the mystery is solved.
You took everything in stride.
It's toilet paper. Yeah.
So that was really good. And then another time when I got in trouble later, I know.
I never
college,
got you mean you got caught. This is what
the police like they actually called and reported the license plate on the car. Do you remember that? Yeah, I won't even get into the details of that.
Rip was learning so much.
That was just.
You're grounded.
The next day, you said to me about these two of the guys that I was with, you said, you will never see them again.
I'm thinking,
like, whatever. They're like, I've been hanging out with them all summer. I never saw them again after that.
That was it.
So. And you would always tell me, it's all about who you are with, and that.
Yes.
Thank you, kids. That it, and you guys can all learn this too. I mean, you probably learned
which
it.
Part? The police.
That it's all about the company. It's all about the company that you keep and the people that are around you. And I tell this to Matilda now
the
time, how much I like her friends.
Right.
Because I know them and I trust them and I'm secure with them and their parents. And yeah, it's always about who you have around you to support you. So not just your family, because your family's not always going to be there, but the, yeah, you know, the other friends that you have.
Yeah.
So
yeah,
that was a lesson that I definitely took and that I passed on to these guys. So Georgia, it's all about the company you keep.
Whatever, but I actually was thinking of a memory related to you, just sort of recent, but it relates to two other women really important to me. Because I was thinking tonight about my mom's 80th birthday. And my mom was a real force of nature. And she came up through a tough time in some ways for women trying to define themselves. And, you know, moving from a place where women didn't have a lot of options to finding options where there were none. As we were walking today, you were reminding me as we were talking about how when Colleen and Aaron were in school, one of your friends was in a community college taking a class and said, you know, oh, I'm taking this class. And you said, oh, wow, I can't imagine doing that. And your friend encouraged you to go ahead and do it. And so you went to evening night school, community college, you know, while you're raising your family. And you kept at it and you got your degree at associate college, and then you went on. And I don't have the timing completely together, but I think you got your BA, you started teaching, and then you met others while you were teaching, and you were realizing that you needed to go on. And you came from a family that where your own mom hadn't gone to college, but you had found a way to do it, and you were in the profession, and then you're going on to get your master's, and you're talking to colleagues and saying, you need to go get your master's, and they're saying, I don't know how I can, you know, and saying, no, you just need to do it, you know. Yeah. And so not only did you do it in record time, but crucial other people in your life followed your example and went on to do great things. And they came back to you and said, you know, what it meant to them, you know, not what you'd pulled off. And I just thought, wow, you know, I know where my wife got her fierceness. you know, just what you have pulled together, not just being a mom and a grandmom, but also a professional and a mentor and, you know, and that sort of thing. It's no small thing. And so here's to you.
Her first day of school was James' first day of kindergarten, so I took him to kindergarten because he was starting her job.
That's awesome.
And when she was working on her master's for a while, she had to go to class, and I had to cook dinner for Dad. And she didn't tell me you needed oil to cook fish.
The only negative.
We have a lot of good time spent together, and I second a lot of things that people have said. I mean, just your drive and, you know, kind of making things happen for yourself and your family has always been inspiring to me, and something that I also see in my mom and something that, you know, drives me in my own life, and I credit a lot of that to you. But something else that I think I've gotten from you and have really fond memories of is being at your house and just spending so much time working on our projects together and learning how to sew and how to quilt and make clothes for myself and, you know, all different kinds of projects that now are like a huge part of my identity. I love working with my hands and I love that kind of practical side and working through things like that, and just being able to, like, as a little kid, be at your house. And, you know, I just, like, remember getting there and you saying, like, okay, like, here's what we're gonna make in this 2 weeks. I'm planning it all out. Yeah, planning it all out and, you know, thinking of what we need to get for it and having our patterns and going to the store and, like, problem solving all those things. And just, like, to think back on that as me being, you know, like a 10-year-old and getting my project and being able to, like, fully realize it and work on it with you is just, like, Yeah, I mean, it was amazing for me, and honestly, it's like a huge part of my life, as Henry can probably attest to. You know, I love those things to this day, and yeah, so
and
thank
And she
you.
Saw that when she in the collection,
yeah.
And she was like, whoa.
you can take a dollar to Hartville.
It was so fun.
I was a certain age, and Grandma was just like, well, you need a collection.
I get the little ceramic animals from the, like, with, like,
yeah.
Teeth.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
I don't have them anymore.
Yeah.
No, you said we were at Hartville.
Yeah.
I said, well, you should collect something. You said, I think I'll collect miniature babies.
I taught you how to bargain for it.
You did. Yeah.
That's what you've passed to all of us.
Oh, yeah.
Caitlin's
the master,
though.
Oh, yeah. Especially
Caitlin.
But the appreciation of, like, a good steal, you know?
This Robert on clears for $7.
Everybody go around and say what they think.
Oh, yeah. That's
true. Oh,
yeah.
Three from between
syndicate.
Yeah,
we all have that in common, don't we?
Yeah.
For sure.
I was thinking about all these really fun memories from hanging out at your house as a kid, which it's been so long since I've been there, actually.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. One is science experiments. We would. Do you remember? Like, we did science experiments in your driveway. like this one that like you put something on paper and it like leaves a shadow from the sun.
We did it on what was it, the 4th
of
the
job.
Oh,
yeah.
That's when I was
out
of town.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Well, yeah, I mean, it's kind of, it seems like a little thing now, but that, I feel like that totally also affected like what I was interested in later on. Science became my thing as a kid, and that was great. I also remember just having really fun times playing games, like, obviously Yahtzee, Pigmania.
Yeah, of course.
And there was I remember laughing so hard a lot during those games, and there was this one time, I don't know what you said, it was just like an expression, like, holy guacamole, or something like that. Was it that? I don't remember what
that
it was.
One of
them. I just thought that was the funniest thing I ever I just, you know, fell over. So
Iris,
just a lot of fun times.
What's it
like? I really like in Christmas time, whenever George is taking a nap, me and Grandma, like, when we got the little dolls, me and Grandma went to the basement, and we used to own, like, little dresses for the dolls we made.
Oh, that's very nice.
Oh, and also, Matilda, remember the dinosaur land?
Oh, yeah. When I was, like, younger, we got a shoebox, and we got, like, these pieces of foam and paper, and we made, like, a whole...
Georgia, do you remember something about Grandma? Something fun you did with Grandma? No. Do you like Grandma?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, she's quiet. I asked her if she remembered.
Georgia, can you go give Grandma a hug?
Yes.
Yeah.
This is the first time I'm going to
go.
Aww.
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 I don't have a specific memory, although I guess maybe it is, I don't know, it's tied to a specific memory, but I was reflecting on when my dad and Colleen first got together, and I don't remember when in the process we met, but I do remember that there was a Christmas, there was a first Christmas that we had together as like a family. I don't know if it was before you guys got married or after. And you like sent me all these presents. and I felt so included, you know? Like I felt like so, like you sent, you know, like you sent the kids a lot of presents, and that was awesome. At that point, you and I didn't know each other very well. And I just felt it was like, yeah, it was, I just, I noticed and I appreciated it, and I was excited about them. I mean,
yeah.
That was great. But I really, like, I feel, I felt like, and I feel like you have sort of consistently gone out of your
way to include, you know, really include Remy and I in your family. And I really appreciate that.
Weird when you would bring like all the like old books that like weren't really good for the classroom anymore. You'd let us like have our pick of all of these books. And until my first year of college, when it literally fell apart, I had A Wrinkle in Time, which is one of my all-time favorite books. Yeah. And it like I'd already it was a paperback, so the front and back covers were already gone. It was in three pieces, held together by duct tape, and I was rereading it for like the 20th time, and I didn't want to get rid of it. I'm like, my grandma gave this to me, but it was already like 15 years old when I got it, so I had to. But like those, that sort of thing means a lot. Like passing forward, like you're saying, not just like academic, like drive, but like no, these are books, and we don't get rid of them.
So you know, mom,
it's always the best time of year when the cookies,
cookies, the time put into it, and when we were getting ready for this, I said, "Well, is it okay if I bake some cookies?" "Sure, mom, you can make some cookies." I didn't know she meant, you know, 100 dozen cookies, but the love of your family, I think you put into your cooking, and.
You get Molly and Lily Christmas presents.
Yes.
It was a little. It's your brand.
It was a little interesting. You know, blending families is always tricky. And you know, when we would do this Christmas cookie baking, it was like we made 20 kinds of cookies. That's what we did. And then we're blending families, and David's like, 20 kinds of cookies.
You want it to be Christmas, don't you?
We found our way. We had a compromise, but I loved those days when we would just spend the day baking cookies. Yeah,
the week.
The week. All right, the week.
Yes. Thank you all so much for being here. And
you can do it.
Can I write it?
We know it's you.
Give me a tissue. Drink some water. You can't cry and drink water. That's a trick.
You know, I was only 18 when we got married. Yeah.
That's crazy.
I had a teen mother.
19.
19-year-old.
And I was 19. Now you're 19.
And, you know, I was so happy to be a mom. I was very young, but
there's like, what's going on?
She said, "You're 19."
But I did the best that I could, and obviously they turned out great.
Yeah,
and gave me these beautiful grandchildren and my bonus grandchildren, and I'm gonna have this great girl. And I just, you're all making me cry.
Wait till you see the cake.
Yeah, let's see the cake. Let's see the cake now.
I'm so overwhelmed by
it. We can tell that.
As you go through life and do these little things that I never realized would make an impression. And I see now that the little things we did that you remembered, and remember that in your own lives, the little things that you do really do count and make a difference in someone's life. And that's important. And that's the most important thing in life. And always remember, all of you, that your family is the most important thing ever. Your family is first. And I thank you all so much for making this wonderful.
Thanks,
my
daughter.
Yeah.
Well, normally.
But, you've all made the effort to be here and to say these wonderful things. And as I said, you don't realize the little things you do to make a difference in someone's life. And I love you all so much.
Yay. Thank you.
Thank you to my wonderful kids for doing this.
Oh, and we've got cake.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
I didn't.
I know it's in Polish, but.
Turn it over. Over, no, other
that's
way.
That's backwards.
It's got to cover
there. There you go.
I don't know.
It may not be you, if
some
but it's
are not,
you know.
We're not the best resolution, but
how did just, you get these?
We're, you know, we're just good kids.
That's Cousin Ian right here when he was a baby.
Yeah, baby.
With the big cheeks.
I wish I didn't do this.
It's cute. It's charming.
I know too.
So anyway, again, I love you. Thank you.
Yes, the Conway kids. And now we have.
Wait, who's coming?
Marcel.
After all that crying, it was time to do the dishes.
Like that's done. And all you need to do is just lift it up and see it's like super hot in there. And then you can just pull it out the other side. You can blow through, pull out, and see like that thing on the bottom turns and sprays. And then all the dishes.
Wait, oh, that's dirty.
These are dirty, yeah. I'm gonna do the silverware though.
Wait, who's rolling for Inside Street?
No one.
I thought
you was.
You're trying to
get. Yes, I was for Inside Street. Like, I got my small street.
It was outside small street.
This is too stressful.
3, 4, 5.
See if we can get one more.
Okay.
Oops, one of those was. You don't do that again, because I don't know what hit me.
Let's pretend.
Okay, ready?
Ready?
We'll fake it.
Yay! It's just as good.
Sunday was all about games and puzzles for everyone.
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Go.
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Captain, you do?
Happy birthday!
Not you.
Happy birthday, Mom!
Happy
Happy birthday, sweetie.
Again?
Happy birthday, Grandma.
Nice.
Good. Yeah,
happy birthday, Mom!
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday. Happy
birthday. Thanks for a great weekend.
Still on the pad.
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Happy birthday, Grandma!
Happy birthday, Mom. I hope you enjoy your birthday.
Video. This is Matilda.
This is Georgia.
Signing out. Happy birthday.